Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to recreate the look of fine art mezzotint prints from your photos. Your images will have all the subtle tonal ranges and textures of authentic mezzotints, even the embossed impression along the edges. My method allows you to quickly replace your image with another without having to redo the effects. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from dreamstime.com. To ensure that your results will look similar to mine, check its resolution by going to Image and Image Size. Make its resolution 150 pixels per inch. We'll convert our photo into a smart object, which allows us to modify it non-destructively, as well as allowing us to replace it with another photo without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. We'll make two copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Hide the two top layers and make the bottom layer active. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Brush Strokes folder and click Angled Strokes. Make the Direction Balance 50, the Stroke Length 30, and the Sharpness 0. Name the bottom layer Angled Strokes. Make the middle layer visible and name it Find Edges Motion Blur. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Find Edges. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the angle 0 degrees and the distance 20 pixels. Change the blend mode to multiply and the opacity to 50%. Make the top layer visible and active and name it Pixelate Gaussian Blur. Go to Filter, Pixelate, and Mezzotint. For the type, pick Fine Dots. Then go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Change its blend mode to hard light and reduce its opacity to 50%. Click the adjustment layer icon, and if you're using version CS6 or later, click Color Lookup. If you're using an earlier version, you can omit this step. Open 3D LUT and click Late Sunset .3DL. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Black White. Since each photo has its own characteristics, it's quite possible that your image may look a bit too dark, as in this particular example. If so, just hide the Color Lookup layer, which will brighten your image. Next, we'll make room for the margins that surround fine art prints. Go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the units of measurement to percent, and in the Width and Height fields, type in 110%. Color Control click or command click the thumbnail of your smart object to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 3 pixels. Go back to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 3 pixels. Scroll to the bottom of the Layers panel and shift-click the thumbnail of the bottom layer to highlight all the layers in the Layers panel. Press Ctrl or Command G to place them into a folder. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the folder. We'll make a new layer below the folder by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with white, and since white is your background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Next, we'll make our mezzotint look like it was pressed into paper. Double-click the folder to open the Layer Style window. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is Linear Burn, the opacity is 10%, and the noise is 50%. The color is black, the technique is softer, the source is edge, the choke is 0, and the size is 5 pixels. Then click OK. To see your entire document, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, I'll show you how to quickly replace your image with another without having to redo the effects. Scroll to the bottom Smart Object and double-click it to open the original source photo. Go to File. If you're using a version earlier than CC, click Open and find and click your replacement photo to open it. Then, drag the photo onto the source photo and resize it using your Transform tool. If you're using version CC or later, click Place Embedded. Locate and click your replacement photo, and then click Place. The Transform tool automatically opens by default. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then click the check mark at the top. Close the tab, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. If you want to give your mezzotint a sepia color, scroll to the top of the Layers panel and make your top layer active. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize, and in the Hue field, type in 33. If you want to give your image the look of denser ink coverage, make the Color Lookup layer visible again. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.